Welcome, today we will learn how to control the water level in the tank using two level probes and a PLC. Before starting, please subscribe this channel to stay connected and press the bell icon to get the notification of the upcoming video tutorials. So let's start today's tutorial and see the setup. We have a water tank, and target is to control the water level in the tank. There is a water level probe I0.2 installed on the water inlet line to detect the water. Water probe is usually installed on inlet supply pipe of the pump, to avoid the dry running of the pump, it could heat, and damage the pump shaft seals. Next, we have installed a inlet valve, at PLC output Q0.0. Next, we have installed a pump to pump the water in the tank, it is connected at Q0.1. Next, low water level and high water level probes are installed, at PLC inputs I0.0 and I0.1 respectively. Next, we have installed a drain valve on the tank, which is controlled by the process. Let's see the ladder logic this setup. In network 1, we insert a normal open contact of auto start bit M10.0. Let's assume that this start bit signal is coming from HMI panel. Next, in series with this start bit, we insert a water probe normal open bit I0.2 and normal close contact of low water level probe I0.0. This means that, if we turn on auto start bit M10.0, from HMI and water probe I0.2, is sensing water in the inlet pipe and water level is below than the low level probe I0.0, it will hold on the inlet valve Q0.0 and water comes towards the pump. In network 2, inlet valve contact Q0.1 is on now, and it will start the 1 second delay timer, and once timer is over, it will start the pump Q0.1 and tank starts filling. Once the water level in the tank reaches the high level probe I0.1, this will opens normal close contact I0.1 and this will unlatch the valve output Q0.0 and turn off pump. Coming back to the network 1, if at any time we disable the auto start bit M10.0, or there is no water in the inlet pipe, it will open the contact of water probe I0.2, and it will unlatch and turn off the inlet valve and pump. Let's upload the program in the PLC and test the programming. You can see that water probe is sensing the water in pipeline, and it's safe to operate the pump now. Water tank is right now almost empty, and below the low level probe I0.0. And this contact is closed right now. As soon as we enable the auto start signal M10.0 bit, it latch on the output Q0.0, for the inlet valve and water moves towards the pump suction side. After 1 second delay, pump output Q0.0 turns on. Now tank starts slowly filling with the water. As soon as water touches the low level probe I0.0, its normal close contact opens up, but the valve and the pump stays on because they are latched on. Now as soon as the water level reaches the high level probe I0.1, its normal close contact opens, and this will unlatch and turn off inlet valve and pump outputs. Process is taking out the water out of the tank via drain valve and water level slowly goes down in the tank. As soon as water level goes below the high level probe I0.1, its contact closes again. Water level in the tank is slowly going down in the tank. As soon as water level goes below the low level probe I0.0, its contact closes again the network 1. And it will latch on again, the inlet valve, and after 1 second pump Q0.0 turns on, and tank again starts filling with water. Now as soon as the water level reaches the high level probe I0.1, its normal close contact opens, and this will unlatch and turn off inlet valve and pump outputs. So, this cycle will continue until we disable the auto start bit, or there is no water in the pump inlet line. That's the end of today's video tutorial. Please share, like, and subscribe for more video tutorials. Until next time, take care and goodbye.